ఆఫ్ఘనిస్తాన్ కి సంబంధించిన అంశంపై అమెరికాలోని వైట్ హౌస్ లో ఫోక్స్ ప్రతినిధులు మాట్లాడుతున్నారు, లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
Countries. Obviously, we're going to work to assess and make sure we get and we work to get as many people out as possible who are eligible for those programs, as well as, of course, separately, American citizens. But I don't have a number or an update for you on the total.
I know they're going to announce this tomorrow, but are we talking about booster shots for everyone? And if so, why should healthy young Americans be getting a third shot when so many in the world don't have a first shot yet?
Well, they will provide a briefing tomorrow on what the recommendations are, and I encourage you to ask a question, as I'm sure you will ask a question at their briefing, Josh, as you've been following this closely. I'm not going to get ahead of their announcement or the president addressing this tomorrow, but I will tell you that we believe that that is a false choice. We can do both, and the United States is far and away the biggest contributor to the global supply, the global fight against COVID. We will continue to be the arsenal for vaccines around the world. We also have enough supply, and we have long planned for enough supply should a booster be needed for the eligible population. Go ahead.
Thanks, Jen. The National Security Advisor said when a civil war comes to an end with an opposing force marching on the ground, there's going to be scenes of chaos. There's going to be lots of people leaving the country. But my question is, why didn't you have a better plan to secure the airport? How could you not anticipate crowds of people rushing the tarmac and overwhelming limited security if there was a contingency plan in place?
Well, first I'd note something that Jake Sullivan said and John Kirby said, which is, and I'll probably butcher their iteration of it, but basically the best laid plans require adjustment when you get on the ground and see what the situation on the ground is. We have secured the airport in a short period of time. There were initial scenes of chaos, but that has been a priority, and we have accomplished that task. Now our focus is on getting planes in and getting American citizens, SIV applicants, our locally employed staff, some of your colleagues out of the country. But we did effectively do that thanks to the hard work of the men and women on the ground from the State Department and the Defense Department over the last 24 to 48 hours. Okay. Oh, I called on you, just let me do one more.
Thank you. Just two quick questions. I want to follow up. Jake said that the president had not spoken to any other world leaders yet. Why is that?
Jake also said that our focus right now has been on operational efforts, which includes coordination at a lower level than leaders and heads of state. And that is our focus on working with third countries to help get their citizens out, or, of course, working with others on the ground to get vulnerable populations out. That's where the focus is at hand right now. And if there is a benefit in the president picking up the phone and calling a world leader, he will certainly do that. And I expect he will do that in the coming days. Thanks so much, everyone. Have a great day.
Thank you.